I'm not afraid of genetic engineering itself. I'm concerned with some applications of genetic engineering that either through, you know, accident or misunderstanding or evil intent could do something potentially harmful.
All right, so you're bringing us to the focus point of our discussion today, which is going to be about the ethical dilemmas, especially for Christians, and how do we handle those? Yeah. Where do we draw the line? So where do we draw the line?
The Christian approach that I take to this, I like to divide it into three categories. The first one is quite simple, the line. We should not be experimenting on other human beings. Humans, according to the Bible, are created in the image of God. We have something no other thing in creation has. We have the ability to know God, to relate to God, to wonder about God. That we're different than all animals. We're certainly different than, like, you know, bacteria and fungi and things like that. So humans are the pinnacle of God's creation. We're the focal point of his plan of salvation. And all, you know, it's all this theological and metaphysical sorts of stuff wrapped up in just being a human. So we should not be experimenting on humans. That's the first level. After that, I'm going to apply something that's called the dominion mandate. That is, in the Garden of Eden, God was talking to Adam and Eve, and he gave them dominion over the birds and the fish and the animals and other things on land. Basically, he said, take care of my creation. And part of taking care of creation is trying to fix things that are broken. And that definitely applies, genetic engineering definitely applies to that. So if we can properly understand our role in God's created world, then genetic engineering might have a place in that role, as long as we're not breaking the thought that humans are made in the image of God. The third, when Jesus was on this planet, he healed a lot of people. And people blessed him for that. Likewise, today you have doctors, and doctors' job is to actually reverse the effects of the curse. They help people. They cure diseases. They prolong life. They make our lives better and more comfortable. And people love doctors because of that. So following Jesus' example, if we can use genetic engineering to improve human life, that's not a bad thing. There are still some huge ethical considerations, which we're going to get to, but those are my three criteria that I use to separate the issues. And if as long as all those things are being fulfilled, then and not broken and not contradicted, then genetic engineering should be okay to apply. I am very excited to offer something to our viewers for free. This is Evolution's Achilles Heels. This is my baby. I spent 3 years working on this, and our team spent 3 years on this. We interviewed a number of PhD scientists who are also Bible believers, and we asked them a simple question. The question was, in your area of expertise, what can evolution not answer? And they said the most incredible things. We call them Evolution's Achilles Heels. We talk about natural selection, genetics, the rock record, the fossil record, radiometric dating, the Big Bang. But we end up with a section on ethics, which is really an opportunity now to talk about the gospel. So we're trying to use science to introduce people to Jesus Christ and the way that they too can go to heaven. Because we see that, you know, the belief in evolution millions of years, evolution specifically, is one of the primary reasons why people reject the claims of Christ. And that's why we do what we do.
We'll make it available in the description.